This is the second part of the boy and his llama painting. This is an acrylic painting, size 10 by 10, and it is recorded on real time. So on this part, you will see mainly more additions on the layers as we go on than the lighter colors. The white color, the white paint has been tinted with the gray, going to the lightest and medium tones, and just keep applying on the textures on the background, the bottom of the, you know, the ground, and then the boy, and as we continue with the llama fur and the texture on those that coat on the llama area. With a fine brush, the tip of the brush is really, really fine. So I proceed to do some outline with the black and then gray just around to create more dimension on the boy's trousers and a few other areas. This is gonna be a black and white painting with one splash of color. So the tree on the far end where the rocky background is, it will be red. So right now, we just, again, with my tiny little brush, the little tip, the fine tip, I went over with the llama's fur on the neck and start doing like a more organic, more loose little strikes. So they start pulling off between all those layers. It is probably like a 3 or 4 layers by now on the overall canvas, and probably a little bit more on the llama fur to create some dimensional, because it will show on your painting. Even though that you are covering one layer after another, if you take the time to place that fur texture, it will show and it create a different look and a quality on your final painting. The llama's eyes is pretty much set in place, and now I'm doing the texture on the blanket that is on the llama's back. So the texture is completely different direction than the fur, so that will make it see some difference between the fur and the blanket that is on top of the animal. So I'm starting also doing some tinting again on the background, on the mountain, far in the mountain in the background, and then in the flat area, the layer flat area where the tree will be set at this point.